Hello everyone, welcome to Sahadhyayana. In this session, we will see three questions which had appeared in GATE. The first one is, the three circuit elements shown in the figure are part of an electric circuit. The total power absorbed by the three circuit elements in watts. So this was appeared in GATE 2014 electrical question paper. So the circuit element has three sources, that is 100 volt, 80 volt and 15 volt source. The current flowing through the 100 volt is given as 10 amps, through 80 volt is given as 8 amps, but through 15 volt it is not given. So let us first denote the power absorbed by this 100 volt as P1, this 80 volt as P2 and 15 volt as P3. So the power absorbed by any element, power absorbed by the element P is equal to V into I, right? So we can calculate P1 easily, P2 also, but P3 we don't know the current. So to know what is the current, so we will apply the KCL at this particular node, okay? So if we apply KCL at this node, so what is the current through 15 volt? It is 10 minus 8, which is equal to 2 amps. Therefore, we can find P1. P1 is equal to, applying this formula, P1 is 100 into 10, which is 1000 watts. Okay, the power absorbed by the 80 volt source, P2 is 80 into 8, but you see the polarity of the voltage source. It's connected to the negative one, that means positive is connected to the other side. It may be connected to ground also. So this is in the negative direction. So it is minus 640 watts. And the last one is, again you see a negative connected to this particular node. So minus 15 into 2 amps, which is minus 30 watts. So we have got P1, P2 and P3. Therefore, the total power which is absorbed by the three circuit elements, total power absorbed by the three circuit elements, is nothing but P equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3. That means 1000 minus 640 minus 30. So this comes to 330 watts. So the answer for this is 330 watts. The next one is, a segment of a circuit is shown in the figure. VR is 5 volt, VC is 4 sine 2t. What is the voltage VL? So this was appeared in GATE 2003 electrical paper. So you can observe here, there is a current source which is 2 amps. You have a junction at this point. I will write the node as A, okay? Node as A. And we have a capacitor, resistor and inductor. Given VR is equal to 5 volt and VC is 4 sine 2t. So we have to find what is VL. So VL is given by L dI L by dt. We will assume that the current flowing through this particular inductor is IL. So VL is equal to L dIL by dt. So to find what is VL, we should know what is IL. Okay. To know IL, we will apply KCL at node A. So how can we find that? So the current which is flowing through the resistor is through the 5 ohm resistor is 5 volt by 5, which is nothing but 1 amps. Then we have to find what is the current flowing through the capacitor. So the current flowing through the capacitor, IC, we'll consider this as IC. So the current flowing through the capacitor IC is equal to C into dVc of t by dt. So C is known, it is 1 farad into d by dt of what is Vc? Vc is given, that is 4 sine 2t. So if we differentiate, we get d by dt 4 into differentiation of sine 2t is cos 2t into 2. So this becomes 8 cos 2t. That is nothing but IC. Now if we apply KCL at node A, what we get is 2 amps plus 1 amps minus IC minus IL equal to 0. 2 plus 1 minus IC minus IL equal to 0. So IL is equal to 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 minus IC. What is IC? We have got it is 8 cos 2t. So 3 minus 8 cos 2t is nothing but IL. So substitute that IL in this VL. Substitute IL in this equation. We are going to get what is VL. So IL is equal to 3 minus 8 cos 2t. Therefore, VL is equal to L dIL by dt. The value of L is 2 and raise divided by d by dt of 3 minus 8 cos 2t. So VL is equal to 2 into differentiation of 3, 0. Minus 8 into differentiation of cos 2t is minus sine 2t into 2. So this is 2 into 8 into 2 becomes 16. 16 sine 2t, or this is 32 sine 2t. So the inductance VL, or the voltage across the inductance VL is given by 32 sine 2t. So the option was B. So B is 32 sine 2t is the answer. The next question appeared in 1997. The energy stored in a capacitor over a cycle when excited by an AC source. Options, four options are provided. First one is same as that due to a DC source of equivalent magnitude. Second one is half of that due to a DC source of equivalent magnitude. Third option is zero. And the last option is none of the above. So first, we will consider a capacitor which is connected across an AC source. Okay, capacitor, the current flowing through the capacitor is I of t, and this is a supply voltage V. So now the current flowing through the capacitor I of t is given by C into dV of t by dt. So this V, assuming it to be sinusoidal, we will take it as Vm sin omega t. Vm sin omega t. Vm we will assume it as 1. So we will write here it as C into d of sin omega t divided by dt. So I of t is equal to C into differentiation of sin omega t is cos omega t into omega. So it becomes omega C into cos omega t. Now the power absorbed is given by V of t into I of t. V of t, we have taken Vm sin omega t, Vm is 1, so it is sin omega t into I of t is omega C into cos omega t, or we can write it as omega C sin omega t cos omega t. So this is sin theta cos theta is sin 2 theta by 2. So this can also be written as omega C into sin 2 omega t divided by 2. omega c into sine 2 omega t by 2. So this is the power. Now how to find the energy over a cycle? So for one cycle, the energy is given. So for one cycle, the energy stored by the capacitor, is E of t is equal to integral 0 to t P of t dt. So we can rewrite it as integral 0 to t P of t. We have got omega c into sine 2 omega t by 2 dt, or we can write this as E of t is equal to integral 0 to t omega c by 2, we take it out, sine 2 omega t dt, or we can write this as omega c by 2, integral sine 2 omega t is minus cos 2 omega t divided by 2 omega, because it is with respect to t, limits from 0 to t. So substitute the upper limit and the lower limit, we get omega c by 4 omega, I take 2 omega out, so I am remaining with minus cos 2 omega t plus cos 0. So this t we can express as omega, we know it is 2 pi f, or this can be rewritten as, instead of it, it is 1 by t. So what is t equal to? 2 pi by omega. So we back substitute it here. So E of t is equal to omega and omega get cancelled. It is c by 4 into minus cos 2 omega into t is nothing but 2 pi by omega plus cos 0. So here again omega and omega get cancelled. Cos 4 pi. Cos 4 pi is 1. So E of t is equal to c by 4 into minus cos 4 pi plus cos 0, which is nothing but equal to 0. So energy stored by the capacitor over one cycle is 0. So the correct option was C. The answer is 0. So if you like the video, please don't forget to subscribe and watch the channel for more such videos on GATE papers. Thank you.